Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 7.4, Problem 2. This is Section 7.4, Problem number 2. It says, consider a normally distributed random variable with a mean mu equal to 180 and a standard deviation sigma equal to 20. Find the following probabilities. Now, A says, what's the probability that X is exactly equal to 150? So for this type of problem, when you have an equal to exactly, zero, automatically. You don't have to do any work. So A is done very easily. Now, B, what's the probability that 165 is less than or equal to X is less than or equal to 210? So in other words, what's the probability that X is between 165 and 210? So again, visually, and you don't really need the visual for this, but I think it helps a lot of people. You'd have a normal curve. The mean would be the middle value, 180. So 165 is a little less. 210 is a little more. And you want the probability of being between that 165 and 210. This is an in-between question. We have to find two chart values for an in-between question and subtract the two chart values. So what we'll have to do is find a z-score for 165 and look it up, and then find a z-score again for 210 and look it up, and then subtract the two answers that we've looked up. So you can do either one first. Might as well start with the 165. I'll go through left to right. You could do the 210 first if you like. So I'm going to start with the formula. Z equals X minus the mean over the standard deviation. And I will fill that in for the 165. So the X is the number I want to convert to a z-score. So that's the 165. Minus the mean is 180 divided by the standard deviation, which is given to be 20. So now in the numerator, if I subtract 165 minus 180, pay attention to your signs, that'll be negative 15 and 20 underneath. So now, you can just divide that out on your calculator. I can see it's negative 0.75. If I reduce both by 5, 5 goes into 15 three times, 5 goes into 20 four times, so I have 3/4, so 3/4, which I know the decimal equivalent is 0.75. Let's say you don't know that. With your calculator, just do negative 15 divided by 20 equals, and however you do it, you're going to get negative 0.75. That's the z-score. That's the number we look up. So, write the number to look up so that it has two places after the decimal, which we have. We don't have to do any work for that. Next, split the number into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. So the 5 comes off to one side. After that, you put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that you pulled off. And now I'm going to go to the negative 0.7 row of the chart. Negative, make sure you pay attention to that, and I'm going to intersect it with the 0.05 column of the chart, and they will intersect at 0.2266. So this is one of my chart values. That's the chart value for the 165, 0.2266. Now I have to do that same process for the 210, get a chart value for that, and then I'm going to subtract those two. So 210, same formula. Z equals X, the number to convert into a z-score, this time is the 210, minus the mean, which is still 180, over the standard deviation, still 20. So, do the math. On top, 210 minus 180 is positive 30. And underneath we have 20. Again, pay attention to positive or negative. So 30 over 20, I can reduce that to 3 over 2, 3/2, 1.5. Again, let's say you don't notice that. Take your calculator, do 30 divide by 20 equals, and your calculator will tell you it's 1.5. So we want to look that up. To look up 1.5 first, write it so that it has two places after the decimal. So 1.5, the way it's written, only has one place after the decimal. So fill in an extra zero, 1.50. Now you have two places after the decimal. Next, split the number into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. So I'll have 1.5 and zero. After that, you put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that you pulled off. So instead of just zero, it's 0.00. And now what I want to do is go to the positive 1.5 row of the chart, positive again, make sure you pay attention to that, and go into the 0, 0 column, the very first column, and where those two intersect, you'll see that they intersect at 0.9332. That's the chart value for 210, 0.9332. So now to find the probability of being between them, I have to subtract those two. So 0.9332 minus 0.2266. And again, you can do that with a calculator. I'm going to have 6. I have to borrow again. 12 minus 6 again is another 6. 2 minus 2 is 0. 9 minus 2 is 7. Bring down my decimal. So 0.7066, almost a 71% probability. And that's the answer for B. So now C, what's the probability that X is greater than or equal to 190? So again, what's this picture look like? So we have a bell curve. The middle value is what is given to be the mean, which is 180. 190 is a little larger than 180, so it would come after or to the right of it. 190. And we're looking for the probability of being bigger than that. So that's what we're looking for. Now, we cannot look up 190 in the standard normal chart. We have to convert it into a z-score, as we've done here, and then look that up. So same formula. I will do z equals x, the number to convert, 190, minus the mean. The mean is 180. Over the standard deviation is 20. And now, if you do the math, in the numerator, 190 minus 180 will be 10. It's a positive 10. You have a 20 underneath, and I recognize that as being 1/2 or 0.5. But again, with your calculator, you could very quickly do 10 divided by 20. Most people would recognize this, but if you don't, you'd get it in a few seconds. So 0.5 is what I need to look up. So in order to look it up, first write it so that it has two places after the decimal. So instead of 0.5, it'll be written as 0.50. Now I have two places. Next, split that number into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. So I'll have 0.5 and 0. After that, put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that you've pulled off, making it 0.00. So now I'm going to go to the 0.5 portion of the positive chart, 0.5 row of the positive portion of the chart. Look in the 0, 0 column, would be the very first column. So you intersect the 0.5 row, the 0, 0 column, they will intersect at 0.6915. Now, the 6915 is actually the blank portion of my drawing because the chart is only set up to tell you what's on the left of what you look up. This particular problem, we want what's on the right. So if this were a less than problem, we'd just stop here. The answer would be 6915. But because it's a greater than problem, I have to do 1 minus the value from the chart. 1 minus 0.6915 would be 0.3085. A little less than a 31% probability of being in that shaded region. And finally, part D. What's the probability that X is greater than or equal to 155? So again, visually, what are we looking for? This is normally distributed, so the picture is a bell curve. The mean will be the middle value. Again, it's given to be 180. 155 is a little less than the 180, so it'll come to the left of it or before it. And this is a greater than question. So I want the portion of my bell curve that comes to the right of my 155 or comes after it. So, like the others, I can't just look up 155 in my standard normal chart. I have to convert it to a z-score. I'm going to use the z-score formula again. So z equals x, the number to convert, 155, minus the mean, or average, 180, divided by the standard deviation, 20. So now on top, I'm going to have 155 minus 180. Again, pay attention to the sign. That's a negative 25. Very important that you don't miss the negative. Positive 20 in the denominator. Now again, I can see I can reduce this by 5. I'd have 5 over 4, 1 and a quarter, 1.25. It's negative. I can see that that's the answer. If you're not as comfortable just writing down the answer as negative 1.25 with your calculator, do negative 25 divide by 20 equals, and the calculator will tell you right away that the answer for that division is negative 1.25. So however you come up with the negative 1.25, now you need to look it up in the chart. So to look it up in the chart, first step of the process is write it so that it has two places after the decimal, which we already have. We don't have to do anything there. The second part of the process is split it into two different numbers by pulling off the rightmost digit. So I'll have a negative 1.2, and I'll pull the 5 off to one side. Now, after you do that, put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that you pulled off. So instead of just a 5, it's a 0.05. Now I go to the negative portion of the chart. Pay attention to which page of the chart you're on. Negative 1.2 row, the 0.05 column, intersect those. They will intersect at 0.1056. Now again, careful, that's not the answer. The 1056 is the blank portion, which I'm not interested in. I want the shaded portion. So again, it's a greater than, all the greater than questions, you have to do 1 minus the chart value. So 1 minus 0.1056 will be 0.8944. So it's almost an 89 and 1/2% probability of being in the shaded region for that one.